Hey besties, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to your girl channel. So y'all, today we are reflecting on 2019 and our goals for 2020. I really don't set goals or whatever, I just kind of just go with the flow. But today we are going to just talk a little bit or whatever. We're just gonna talk a little bit. So I hope that everyone had a great Christmas and, you know, Happy New Year to you all. I hope this new year is filled with nothing but blessings for you guys. And yeah, so I wrote down everything that I want to talk about. This video it's not gonna be a perfect video. I'm just gonna be talking to you guys. Like, I don't want it all over the place, but still just having a conversation with you guys. So I wrote down my goals, well, my 2019 and 2020 right here. So it kind of looks like a lot, but it's really not. So let's get into it.
I like the way she works. She always puts me first. Why you got the best on earth?
On the floor and it's getting nasty. He ain't keeping his hands up off my ass cheeks. I got something to give him, and if he
So my biggest accomplishment for 2019 was I went to 2 states in 1 year. 2 states in the same year. My first place I went to was New York, and then my second place I went to Miami. Between New York and Miami, I enjoyed maybe New York the most because I looked at it as a experience. Definitely all over experience. It made me think about and just be grateful for what I have, due to the fact just for one, everything is so expensive. Okay, so when you come to Georgia, everything isn't expensive like New York. For two, when I rode on the subway so we can get to where we were going, I'm like, this is how people really actually live their lives. Like, they have to ride on the subway. They have to have their kids with them and, you know, on the subway. This is how they grocery shop. Subway. This is how they get to work. Subway. You know, walking. I never did so much walking in my life. The coldness, oh my God, it's so, like, it will definitely take your breath away. It, like, Georgia, this, they're cold, and this cold, how it gets in Georgia, is nowhere near compared to their cold. Like, their cold is on a whole nother different fucking level cold, okay? So it just made me appreciate everything, and the experience was amazing. New York was so beautiful, y'all. Like, it was very beautiful. I would definitely go back again. I probably wouldn't go back during the winter time, but I would definitely go back during the summertime. So yeah, Miami was beautiful too. So another accomplishment was just getting on a plane in general, because I have always told myself, girl, you're not getting on a plane, but I did it. And I'm so glad that I did it. I was scared. I'm not even going to lie. I was scared. Going to New York, we traveled Delta. Coming back from New York, we traveled Delta. We flew Delta. Going to Miami, we did American Airlines, and coming back from Miami, we did Delta. So Delta was really, I like Delta a lot. The experience, just my ears were like, oh my God, my ears, I don't even want to talk about it, my ears were like popping so bad, y'all. We stayed in New York. From when I went to Miami, my ears didn't do that. But New York, we stayed in New York from Thursday to Sunday. Y'all, I swear to God, from Thursday to Saturday, my ears were hurting so bad. But I didn't care. The experience was just so amazing. So, yeah, flying, yes. a big accomplishment for me. I would definitely get on a plane anytime. It doesn't even matter. My lips look white, but it's my lipstick, so y'all don't mind it. Okay, so another accomplishment for me this year, I started my YouTube channel, which was a very big accomplishment for me because I have always wanted to do it for years, but I felt like I didn't have the tools and stuff to start a channel, so I just didn't do it. So one day, I just was like, I want to really actually be, you know, serious about starting my channel, and that's what I did. The lighting, y'all, I can't wait to get my ring light. Excuse me. Can't wait to get my ring light so my lighting for my videos can be so much better. I want a camera, but I'm currently recording from my iPad, which is cool. You know, I don't have an issue with that, but I really want a camera. So I'm going to start small first. Just start small. You can start your channel. I always thought I needed, like, the big things, lights, cameras, computer, to start my channel. And you really don't. You just use what you got to get what you want. Period. No, for real. Start your channel. If that's what you want to do, start it. No matter what you have, start it. This is the best thing I have ever did. I love being a YouTuber. So, yes. And I'm just a firm believer that everything happens when the time that it's supposed to happen. So, yeah. That's how I feel. Another thing that 2019 has taught me is to stop giving chances to people who don't appreciate you. Just stop dealing with people who are just unappreciative, period. 2019 has definitely taught me that, literally. And also, 2019 has taught me, like, everybody's energy isn't meant for your energy or your spirit. So, it just doesn't meet. So, stop trying to force it. You just have to just keep moving it and just keep doing you. Life goes on no matter what. Because no one is going to look out for you how you look out for yourself. And that's just that. Okay, that's the God and His truth. 2019 has definitely taught me patience, and to be more appreciative of what I have. Not saying that I'm not, but just to be more appreciative what I have and where I am in life, because it's somebody out there that wants to be where you at that isn't where you at, and it's someone that's, you know, don't have the things that you have. I don't care if it's the small things. So, yeah. 2019 also has taught me to do more for myself and others. Let me push that back. 2019 has taught me to do for others. Okay? Because I feel like I don't have no kids. I'm not in a relationship. So, I feel like sometimes it's okay. Like, I'm very selfish with myself. So, I look at stuff like it's all about me and nobody else. Okay? But not in a bad way. It's just like everything is all about me. You feel me? So, I just learned to be more like giving. Like, try to help if I can, if I got it. I'm just learning to do for people what they would do for you. I'm so blessed and grateful. So, 2019 has definitely taught me to just be open. Just be open and be giving and be loving more and stuff like that. So, yeah. But it definitely has taught me patience. What I do want to work on, my goals for 2020, what I do want to work on, I am a person where I worry a lot and it makes me sad, because I can't help it. I just can't. I deal with that so badly, you guys. Like, so badly. I worry myself to death. And I am trying to be better with that. I'm also trying to learn to take stuff for what it is. Because me personally, I'm a person where in certain situations, though, I am like, okay, fuck it. Like, whatever. It is what it is. But sometimes, like, I just keep dwelling back on the situation and just keep thinking about it and keep I just want to be better with overthinking myself and putting too much stress on myself, because I do it a lot. And my mom and my sister get on to me about that all the time. But, you know, no matter how much someone tells you, girl, stop doing it. I mean, I just can't help it. I'm trying. I'm really trying. I'm trying. Your girl gonna get it. Your girl gonna get it. I know I'm not the only one out there that overthinks everything. Like, my brain is it's just always huge. Just, I have so many things playing in my head at one time. I worry too much. I worry too much. And I'm gonna do better. I'm gonna do better. I got to work on that. And it's gonna take some time, but I'm gonna work on it. Another thing I do wanna work on in 2020 is second guessing myself. I second guess myself a lot. Like, I can know something is definitely right, and I just second guess myself a lot. And I hate that I do that, because it takes up too much time. Just being real. Takes up too much time on my end and for myself, just second guessing for no reason. Yeah, I got to do better, and I am. Another goal for 2020, I really don't set goals, but these are my goals as far as my mental state and just me in general, for myself to be better for myself. So I am gonna set those goals, but like, far as like, just setting goals, I normally don't do that, but I really do want to be just better. I want to become a better person day by day, just grow. My goals for 2020 is also to just put out more content for my channel. I want to make more videos, come with you guys, because you guys are my besties. Like I said, when you come over here, we become besties. And yeah, I just want to, you know, when I created this channel, I was kind of scared. I am a woman and I am confident in myself, okay? But when you make a YouTube, the whole world sees you. Period. The whole world sees you. And you have to be ready for that. So, it's kind of scary. But, you know, you girl stepped out on faith. You know, just, I got strong enough to make a channel. So, yeah. I just want to put out more content for you guys. I want to be a better individual, just period. I ask God all the time, make me a better person day by day. Because, y'all, I'm not going to lie to y'all. Like, 2 or 3 years ago, like, my attitude was so horrible. And I didn't know why. I didn't know why, like, I was so angry or so mean or just nasty. Like, I didn't know why. And I'm like, you know what? I told myself one day, I don't want to be that person where people be like, she got a nasty attitude. Because I used to always hear, you're so pretty, but your attitude is horrible. And it was the truth. But I'm so glad that as of today, just in general, as of today, yesterday, just starting to change, period. I can be a woman and admit that, like, my attitude was horrible. But, y'all, I feel so different. Like, I'm so glad and so proud of myself. The things I used to get mad about and trip about, I don't even trip over that shit no more. Period. Like, for what? It's too much energy. Like I said, I asked God to make me a better person. Just, I want to be better by the hour, by the minute, by the second, by the days, by the month. I just want to be a better me, for me, to help me grow. I'm still learning myself. I'm still growing. I'm still just trying to figure out who I am. And there's nothing wrong with that. I don't give a damn if you're 30 years old and you don't know who you are yet. There's nothing wrong with that. try to figure yourself out. Do what you need to do to try to figure you out. You got some people that really don't figure out who they are until they're 40, 45, 50. It doesn't matter. You know you how you know you. No one can tell you anything about you but you. So figuring yourself out, it is okay. We slip, we fall. Long as we can be strong enough and pick ourselves back up, that's all that matters. All that matters. I promise y'all. So figuring out yourself, ain't nothing wrong with that. Nothing is wrong with that. I remember my mom used to ask me, like, do you know who you are? And I'm like, yes, Shakira Owens. Of course. She was like, that's not telling me who you are. You don't know who you are. And she's so right. She was right. And now that I'm an adult like I am, I get it. I so get it, y'all. I don't know who I am. I'm still learning myself. And that is okay. That is okay. I'm still trying to figure it out. Like, y'all have so much stuff that I done did and still trying to do. Just trying to figure me out mentally. Definitely mentally. It's okay. But that's why you have to surround yourself with positive people, positive energy. Stay positive. You know, we get knocked down sometimes, but it's okay. Like I said, get yourself back up. Pull yourself back up. Do what's best for you. It is okay. It is okay. And you got to do it for you. Okay? Because if you're not going to do it, no one is going to do it for you. We're grown. We're grown. You got to keep moving. You can't stop. You can't stop. Because one thing about this world, I don't give a damn about you. Period. We can't stop. We got to keep going. Whatever it is you want to do, everything takes time. Just because this person is in whatever in their life, it's cool. It's okay. It's not you to worry about. It's not your blessing or not your success that's happening. So don't look at someone else's success like, oh my God, I can't believe they're there. I wish I was there. No, you're going to get there because guess what? They probably worked their ass off to get there. So you have to make sure that you do the same. Okay? And us as women, we always tear ourselves down. Us as women, we always having other women to tear us down. We're tearing down each other. And instead of just being a sisterhood and uplifting each other, women don't know how to do that. Okay? They don't know how to do that. I don't know what's wrong, but I'm not going to try to figure it out because I don't want none of that negativity around me, period. I just don't. So, we got this. Let me see. I just really want us to grow as women and start realizing our worth, not even just with men or dating or whatever we're doing, just our worth with ourselves. You know, I feel like that's very important. Like, you got to know your worth with yourself, because if you don't know your worth with yourself, then how can you expect for somebody else to give you what you need or what you're looking for when you don't even love yourself or know your worth with yourself? It doesn't work like that. Work on you first. Please work on you first, because dealing with somebody and wanting somebody to love you, you're not going to get anywhere. You're still going to be unhappy if you're not loving yourself. Because guess what? If you love yourself so much, you won't even be dealing with bullshit. Period. At all. Okay? Oh, and also 2020, I want to do more trips. I want to take more trips. I'm trying to take a trip out the country. So, you know, you girl trying to get that going. I want to take a trip out of the country. I'm kind of scared and nervous. There's so much going on. You just don't know what they expect. So, I did want to take a trip. 2020, I'm your girl getting her ring light. Okay? Okay. So, also 2020, I want to gain more followers, more subscribers. I want to gain more besties. More followers on Instagram. So, I want all that. And I want to get my stomach cut off. 2020, chop that shit off. Cook that shit up, Quay. Chop that shit out, Quay. We need to be gone, period. You don't need to be here. I want to get my stomach chopped off, okay? So, we're going to see about making it happen. We're going to see what we can do. But yeah. So those are my goals. Those are my reflecting back on 2019, my little goals for 2020. Just I hope and pray that everybody out there, all my besties, you guys just continue to love yourself, hug yourself, look yourself in the mirror and say, you know, girl, you got this. It's going to be okay. You know, we're going to grow together. Okay, love yourself more. Do something nice for yourself. I don't care if you have to go get your nails done. Buy yourself flowers. Y'all, let me tell y'all, I talk to myself on a daily. Okay, I'm not crazy, but I do talk to myself on a daily because I'm just like, bitch, you are that bitch, period. Okay? Sometimes you just need a little pep, like a little pep talk with yourself. Like, baby, look. Baby, look now. Wait. Oh. I look good today. Okay. Whatever makes you feel happy, do it. Your friends make you feel happy. Have a girls' night. Whatever it is, surround yourself with nothing but love and positivity. Just positive people, good energy. You know, I feel like everyone needs that. If it's negative, toxic, leave it at the door. You don't need that in your life, especially if you're at a point in your life where you're trying to literally, like, legit find yourself and be a better person and be happy. You don't need that toxic shit because they are in the dark, okay? Toxic people are in the dark. You ain't trying to be in the dark. You trying to pull yourself. That's not what you're trying to do. Let them be in the dark alone and let them be toxic on their own, okay? You don't need that. It's not healthy for you. So, excuse me, it's not healthy for you. So, yeah, besties, we women, girl power, period. We got this. We're going to keep striving. We're going to keep doing us. We're going to keep being beautiful. We're going to glow the fuck up. We're going to focus on ourselves. We're going to love ourselves more. We're going to kiss ourselves like, bitch, you got this, period. That's all you got to do. We're going to take care of ourselves. We're going to look beautiful. Yeah, I'm not saying you have to dress up every day. But, bitch, look beautiful, you know, on the weekends or whenever. I'm just saying. Someone needed to hear this, okay? Somebody needed to hear this. So, y'all, I love you guys. I'm definitely going to do a look on how I get my makeup this glowy. Because been getting a lot of questions about my makeup and it looks so bomb. So I'm definitely gonna do a video on this look, how I get this makeup look. So I will see you guys in my next video, besties. I love you guys. Hit that like button to like my video, subscribe to my channel, hit that notification bell to be notified every time you bestie upload a motherfucking video, okay? Period. So hit that subscribe button. Yeah, so subscribe to my channel. If you're new to my channel, I am Kira. Welcome. We are besties over here. And yes, I love you, besties. See you soon.